morning, everybody. Happy Friday. TGIF. Power of Christ. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We are free in Jesus' name. God is fighting for us, y'all. He fought for us all week long, and we made it. Our burden, he has overcome. He has overcome. Be shaken. We will not be shaken. We will not be moved. Come on. I will live. Good morning to you all. Not seeing comments yet, but I know you're here, and I know you're praising with me, and we're thanking God that we made it. I will not die. I will see lift you high. Good morning, good morning. We're just praising God this morning. Come on, God is fighting for you this morning. Hey, Suzanne. Hey, Deanna. Good morning, Sister Irene. Hey, Nyoka. Nikki. It's good to see you. Praise God. Hey, Sister Cheryl. I'm just jamming this morning. Come on and jam with me. God is fighting for us. The kingdom. Come on, I want you to praise with me this morning. Defeated, and we will shout it out, come on. God is fighting for you, Sister Cheryl, for you, Nyoka, for you, Deanna, for you, Suzette. God is fighting for you. God is fighting for you, Denise. You know he's fighting for you. He's fighting for you, Irene. He's fighting for you, Sis Nyoka. He is fighting with everything he's got. And you know God's powerful. Nikki, he's fighting, girl. He's pushing. That cannot be shaken in the name of, come on, the enemy's defeated. We say it this morning, in the name of Jesus, the enemy's defeated. Come on. I will not die. Y'all just excuse me while I jam it out this morning, because I know God is fighting for me. See, I can fight, but I can't fight like God. I will not die. Declare and lift you high. As y'all are coming on, share this video with others. Click share. For us, pushing back the darkness. Come on, he's pushing back the darkness. Hey, Deborah, good morning. The enemy's defeated, and we will shout it out. Hey, Jeanette, good morning. God is fighting for you, pushing back the... Come on, what is he pushing back in your life right now? He's holding it off, he's holding it off. The enemy's defeated, and shout it out. Come on, you gonna shout it out this morning? Pushing back the darkness. Don't mind me, y'all. I'm just getting my praise on this morning. Because it's been a week. And God, I pushed through. God, pushed through the darkness. Enemies defeated. Oh, he's defeated. Oh, he's been trying me, y'all, just like he's been trying you. But he was not successful, because here we are this morning. We made it, y'all. The enemy's defeated, and we will shout it out. Kingdom that cannot be shaken in the name of Jesus. The enemy's defeated. Come on, how many of you can say that this morning? In the name of Jesus. The enemy is defeated, and we're going to shout that. What you say, Jeanette? You want to see me be just a little bit more bold? Listen, if I can't be bold at this point, if I can't be bold for Jesus, I will never be bold, because he has brought me through too much for me to be passive, for me to be quiet about the amazing God he is. And God has brought all of you out of something. There's some darkness that he has pushed back on your behalf. The enemy is defeated. Brother Bobby, it's great to see you. Hey, Regina, good morning. Listen, I'm praising God, because I don't know about you, but maybe you didn't come up under any attacks. I don't know. Maybe you didn't, so maybe you can't understand. I said it before that, you know, you can't understand my praise if you have not experienced my pain. Come on. Right? See, you know, somebody that may not have experienced what you've experienced, have not come through what you come through, are not pushing through what you're pushing through, they looking at your praise, they like, well, it don't take all that. Well, you don't know what it takes. You don't know what I did. You know, what I had to do to get to this place where I can even praise God. So listen, excuse me while I praise God, because listen, trust me, the enemy has been busy all week long, and I'm just praising God. Hallelujah. It is Friday, and I am here, and I'm in my right mind, and God is good. Amen. Anybody agree with me this morning that God is good? Father God, we just come to you this morning, Father God, with our hands raised high. If you can raise your hands, just raise your hand this morning. Somebody wants to raise their hands, and they can't. We just raise our hands to you this morning, God, and we just say we love you, God, with all of our heart, God. We love you. We thank you for who you are. We just praise you this morning. We thank you, God, for how you fight for us. We thank you, God, for your favor. We thank you, God, for your protection. We thank you, God, for the wisdom that you so freely give us. We thank you, God, for this, our encouragement and prayer family, God, where we can just come together and be encouraged by you and encourage and uplift each other, Father God. We thank you, Father God, that we're on the wake up list today. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Some didn't make it, God, but we are here. So we're here with grateful hearts this morning, thanking you, God, for being the Almighty God. And while you're Almighty God, you're still Abba Father, Daddy. Thank you, God. So Father God, we just thank you in advance for your word that's going to go forth this morning. We thank you, God, that I believe that this word is going to encourage our spirits, is going to give us that little extra push that we need today. So we say, Holy Spirit, you be the teacher. You give us revelation. You give us affirmation, confirmation. Whatever it is that you want to send our way today, help us to be hearers of the word and doers of the word. Help us to believe it and receive it. And help us to respond accordingly. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Hey, Anne Marie, good morning. Hey, Sister Karen, good morning. Tangia, good morning. Good morning to everybody. Oh, I know what you meant, Sister Jeanette. Amen. We missed you last night, but I pray that all is well. And it's so good to see you this morning, Sister Jeanette. So, I was going to say something and I lost my train of thought, but it's all good. So, do me a favor, make sure that you click like or love or whichever one with the heart or whatever. And then please click share and let others know that we are jumping into the word this morning. And if you are ready, just say ready. I'm ready. And we're going to jump into the word this morning. As I was studying this morning and just asking God what he would have me to share with you, hey, Sister Angela, I just, this leaped into my spirit, and I thought about each of you, and I was like, yeah, God, this is such an amazing word to finish up our week, to end our week together, our EP family. So just know that I love you all with all my heart. But even more important, God loves you. Amen. So we are going to be in the book of Luke. Luke chapter 22, verses 31 and 32. Thank you to someone for putting that in the chat for me. Luke 22, 31 and 32. Hear the word of God. Simon, Simon, this is Jesus speaking. He says, Satan has asked to sift you as wheat. But I have prayed for you. This is Jesus. But I have prayed for you, Simon, that your faith may not fail. And when you have turned back, strengthen your brothers. I'm going to read that. That was in the NIV version. But I'm going to now read it in a translation called The Voice. The Voice translation. The same scripture, Luke 22, 31 and 32. Hear this translation, the word of God. Jesus says, Simon, Simon, how Satan has pursued you. Anybody feels like the enemy has been pursuing you, has been on your tail, has been in your neighborhood, has been on your block, has been in your house? Come on, anybody feel like the enemy has pursued you? He says, the enemy has, Satan has pursued you that he might make you part of his harvest. Ugh. But I have prayed for you. I have prayed that your faith will hold firm and that you will recover from your failure and become a source of strength for your brothers. Oh my goodness. Jesus says the enemy is intent on pursuing you. He is intent on pursuing you, Irene, Angela, Deanna. You understand? He's on a mission. He's gunning for you. But Jesus says, he says, I have prayed for you. He has prayed for you that your faith will hold firm and that you will recover. Somebody say that this morning. I will recover. I need you to say that. I will recover. That regardless to what the enemy throws at me, to regardless to what blindsides me, regardless to what disappoints me, I will recover. I need you to get that in your spirit this morning. I will recover. You will recover, Nikki. You will recover, Sister Denise. You will recover, Ortega. You will recover, Jeanette. He says, I have prayed for you that you will recover from your failure and become a source of strength for your brothers. In this passage, Jesus is telling Simon that the enemy, Simon Peter, that the enemy has made it his mission to pursue him. And so, you know, the question, it begs itself, why did the enemy choose Peter? Why is he going after Peter? Why did he choose you, Regina? Why did he choose you, Denise? Why you, Tega? Why you, Suzette? Why did he choose you? Well, I've heard it said that a thief never breaks into an empty house. Help me, Holy Ghost. That when a thief breaks into a house, it's because he believes or she believes that that house has something valuable in it. I'm trying to talk to somebody this morning. And that the reason why the enemy was pursuing Peter was because he knew that Peter had value for the kingdom. That Peter was valuable to the kingdom. Somebody say, I am valuable to the kingdom. I need you to understand something this morning. Because the enemy is not, you're not going through what you're going through because you're a bad person or because you did something bad. You're going through what you're going through because you add value to the kingdom. That the enemy, he wants to break in and steal what is valuable. And so the enemy wanted Peter because he knew that Peter brought value to the kingdom. Jesus had great plans for Peter. As impulsive as Peter was, y'all know Peter, like self-discipline was far from Peter at times. Peter was that one that whatever he opened his mouth, just whatever he was thinking just tripped out. You know, Peter didn't really know how to hold his temper, that whatever he felt, he said it, and whatever he felt and what he said, you knew it. That was Peter. And yet, help me, Holy Ghost. And yet God had, Jesus had plans for Peter. So no matter what you think your failures are, your little quirky ways and those things that you may still struggle with, it does not stop God from using you in the kingdom because you have value. Jesus says in Matthew 16 and 18, he says, "Now I say to you that you are Peter, which means rock. And upon this rock, I will build my church." Jesus had plans for Peter. He said, "I will build my church, and all the powers of hell will not conquer it." Jesus had plans for Peter. God had plans for him. God has plans for you, Regina. God has plans for you, Suzette. God has plans for you, Tega. God has plans for you, Priscilla. And oftentimes we feel like maybe God can't use us because of things that we have done and things that we're experiencing and things that we are going through. But just like Willie said last night, you know, we have to remember that the very things that we believe disqualify us are the very things that qualify us for God's use. It was that same impulsiveness. It was that same aggressiveness. It was that same, I don't care what you think, that God used Peter when he was sharing the gospel. You understand? God's not trying to change you to have you carry the gospel. He's just trying to use all your spunk, all your tood, all of that. He's using it for his glory. And so God has great plans. He says, "I'm going to build," he told Peter, he says, "I'm going to build my church upon you. You are Peter the rock, and all the powers of hell will not be able to prevail against it." The enemy, listen, because God has great plans for you and for me, the enemy is pursuing us. The enemy, listen, the enemy is trying to recruit for his harvest. It's not just the kingdom of light that's trying to build a harvest. The enemy is trying to build a harvest too. He's trying to build his own army, and he's looking for recruits, y'all. And can I just tell you something? Let me just encourage somebody this morning. He's not looking for the wishy-washy. He's not looking for the lukewarm. Help me, Holy Ghost, today. You understand? He's looking for warriors. He's looking for people like you, people like me, that we've been beaten up but not beaten down. I'm talking to somebody this morning where you've been pushed to your limit, but you refuse to give up. You refuse to quit. See, that's who he's looking for. He's not looking for folk who are lazy and making excuses and are not committed. He's looking for those committed. He's looking for you, and he's wanting to recruit you to his side. Oh my goodness. He's looking for those of us who give in God our strong yes. Hey, Brother Todd, because if you give God a strong yes and he can bring us to his side, then he's got a strong yes on his side. But here's the thing. He's looking for warriors like you, warrior like me. Why? Because after we have come through, after we have overcome, we become warrior makers. Who am I talking to this morning? You're a warrior maker. Not only are you a warrior, but now you turn around looking to see who you can encourage, who you can strengthen, who you can give hope to, who you can let them know, if God did it for me, he'll do it for you. See, that's the whole thing. See, Jesus said to Peter that once he came through the test, that he will strengthen others. Yes, of course, the enemy is trying to stop you, but it's bigger than you. Somebody say, it's bigger than me. He knows that when you are strengthened, that when your resolve is thick, that when you have become solidified in what you believe, when you know that you are truly a conqueror, he knows that you're going to turn around and you're going to strengthen some folk. So he's not only trying to block you, but he is trying to block the warriors in making. Help me, Holy Ghost. He's trying to discourage you from spreading hope. He's trying to discourage you from letting others know that there is a God who loves them. He's trying to, you know, I remember, help me, Holy Ghost. Yes, Angela, you are a warrior maker. You understand? You are a recruit for the kingdom. It is bigger than you. I remember back in 2013, somewhere around there, 2012, 2013, I went through what I believe was one of the biggest fights of my life, where I was a part of a church, and it was some serious church hurt going on, and I was pushing, because I had really believed that after serving for so many years, that God was taking me kind of from behind and moving me to the forefront. But it wasn't anything that I was doing. It's clearly what God was doing, because at this point I had released my first book, The New Consecrated Cocoon, and doors were open. And people were coming to me to, you know, pray over them, and there were some folk that saw this stuff happening and felt like I was trying to usurp authority, and I was trying to make my name great, and I was trying to do some things, but they were sadly mistaken. It was just my time, that God was doing something, and he was birthing the ministry in me, and he was, and there was some folk that really just gave me a hard time about that, and wanted to make me feel like I was out of place, out of step, out of touch with God. And I now think about that thing, and I realize that clearly when all of that was coming against me in 2013, the enemy saw each and every one of your faces in 2021. That what he was trying to stop me from was believing that God can use me. See, had I not broken out of help me, Holy Ghost. You understand? Man wanted to limit me. Man wanted to put me in a box. Man wanted to tell me how they saw God using me. And if I had listened to man, I would not be sitting here on this Facebook Live with each of you. So what I'm saying is that as I am being obedient to God, I desperately want God to use me to strengthen others. And so the enemy had a plan way back then that included you, that he didn't want me to get to you. He didn't want me to be able to do a live to strengthen people all around the. He didn't want that. And you better believe he doesn't want it from you either. That's why he's pursuing you. That's why he's trying to stop you. That's why he's trying to discourage you. I'm trying to talk to somebody today that, yes, you, that you, well, Sister Ann, I don't feel like I'm called. We're all called. Sister Ann, I don't feel like I can minister. You are a minister. Sister Ann, I don't know. You have a gift. You stop waiting for somebody else to approve and tell you, oh, we want you to serve on this ministry, and we want you to, come on, stop waiting for that. Know that God has called, equipped, anointed you. And you are a warrior maker. And you don't need permission from no person to do that. He's trying to block the warriors in the making. The warriors that God is that he's wanting to, the lives that God wants to touch and impact through you. The enemy wants to discourage you from spreading hope. So I can see it now. I didn't see you. I didn't see you, Regina. I didn't see you, Priscilla. I didn't see you, Jeanette. I didn't see you, Suzanne. I didn't see none of y'all, Brother Bobby, in 2012, 2013. But the enemy, he got a glimpse. of what God was getting ready to do. He sees, the enemy sees your children. He sees your family members. Help me, Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody, I'm talking to you this morning. He sees your co-workers. I'm talking to somebody. If you're in school, he sees your fellow, the other people that you're in class with. He sees that. He sees the people that you work with. He sees the people in your neighborhood. He sees it. He sees what God is wanting to do. And so if he could just discourage you, if he wants you to not recognize that you will recover, you understand, it's bigger than you. It's not just you. It's everybody that you are assigned to. But I love it that Jesus said, this is so amazing. Jesus says in verse 32, he says, but I have prayed for you. Jesus has prayed for you. He says, I prayed for you. I pray that your faith will hold firm. That's my prayer for you this morning. That though your faith is tested, is tried by fire. Some of you are in the fire right now, but you need to know you will recover. He says, I pray that your faith will hold firm and that you will recover from your failure. And listen, this is so good. This is so good. That you will recover from your failure and become a source of strength. Somebody say, I am a source of strength. And become a source of strength for your brothers, your sisters. Now strengthen your brothers and your sisters. And listen, you don't have to wait until you've come all the way through to do that. You understand? I have learned that some of my best times of ministering and encouraging and lifting other people up is while I am going through. See, if the enemy can cause you to feel that you have nothing to contribute, then that's how he shuts us down. But yes, even in the midst of what you are experiencing right now, what you are fighting to have, what you're fighting to believe, what you're fighting to do, you are a source of strength for somebody else. Do not think it's strange when folk send you an inbox or somebody just calls you out of the blue or somebody texts you. Listen, let's stop looking at things as an inconvenient. Oh, well, I don't have time for this. Listen, if God placed you on their heart, then you have what they need. I'm going to say that again because sometimes we look at stuff. Well, why she texting me? She don't never text me. Oh, why they texting me after all this time? Or why they reaching out to me? I ain't never heard that. But listen, if God put them on your heart, put you on their heart, then he has given you something for them. You are a source of strength. And stop looking at yourself and stop looking at your situation and doubting whether or not God can use you. If they contact you, then you need to rise up in the name of Jesus, in the authority given, and out of your faith, let your faith overflow. You know, be an encourager. Raise up another warrior. Come on, let's stop just looking at ourselves and feeling sorry for ourselves. Yes, the enemy is pursuing you. Yes, stuff is coming against you, but Jesus is praying for you. You ain't got no better prayer warrior than Jesus. I know you done called pastor, and you done called the prayer team, and you done called the elders, and the deacon, and prophetess, and prophet, and all the people that you calling. Jesus is praying for you. And what he's praying is that for your faith will not fail. And that while your faith is being strengthened, that you will look around and go, who can I bless? Who can I encourage? And you know what? I'm going to tell you what's really encouraging. When I talk to folk and realize that they're encouraging me in the midst of their situation. Listen, it's one thing to encourage folk after the fact. Well, yeah, you know, I came through that and it was powerful. I mean, I came through and God used, you know, God did this and God did that. And I thank God I came through it. But how about you talk to somebody and say, yeah, I'm in the midst of that right now, but I am trusting God. Right now it still hurts, but I'm trusting God. Yeah, right now I'm walking by faith because it don't look nothing like what God said. Not yet. I'm still in pain. My marriage is still in shambles. I'm still lonely. I'm still broke. I'm still, but I trust God. Because I will recover. Strengthen somebody today because God is your source. Jesus is your source because he is praying for you. Listen, God is going to lay some folk on your heart this morning. And I'm do whichever one you want to do. You might want to tag them right now. Tag them, put their name in the chat and just tag them and say, you will recover. Share this message to their timeline or send it in their inbox or just send somebody a text. And just say, you will recover. Let them know there is hope in Jesus. Let them know that not only are you praying for them, but Jesus is praying for them too. Because they got folk that God is going to use them to strengthen and encourage. But guess what? It starts with you. It starts with me. Knowing and believing beyond a shadow of a doubt that whatever we are going through right now is not going to take us out. We will recover in Jesus' name. I pray this message just lit a fire up under somebody that you came here today and the enemy, he was on your tail and he was talking in your ear and he was discouraging you and he was telling you that you ain't making it out of this one and he was telling you look, everybody looking at you and you look weak and he was all these lies that you ain't got nothing to offer, that you ain't got nothing to say, that you look at you, God can't use you. I'm saying the enemy has been on some of your tails this morning. He has been in your ear. He has been talking to you. You'll always be. You'll never have. You'll never do. He's been talking to you, but I need you to put him on notice this morning, and I need you to let the enemy know, let the kingdom of darkness know that you are not a recruit for him, that you are a recruit, help me, Holy Ghost, for the kingdom of light, that you are for the kingdom of God, that is who, help me, Holy Ghost. You understand? You put him on notice this morning. Let's stop with the pity parties. Let's stop looking inward and start looking upward. Let's, you understand, put him on notice this morning. I don't care what you came on this live feeling like. You need to leave this live different, with a pep in your step, with some wind beneath your wings, whatever it is, but you need to leave here differently this morning, understanding that the enemy might be on a mission, but God has a mission for you, and Jesus is praying you through, because you will recover. And when you recover, you are going to look back and you are going to strengthen those around you. The enemy is not just after you, but he's after all those who God is going, God plans on using you to strengthen. Father God, we thank you for this word today. I do pray, Lord, that it fanned the flame up under somebody this morning who showed up here, you know, feeling alone, feeling misunderstood, feeling downtrodden, you know, full of grief, full of discouragement. Father God, lift your son, lift your daughter this morning. Lift their head, Father God, and let them know that they are valuable to your kingdom, that you have work for them to do, Father God. And we can't do work when we're sitting around feeling sorry for ourselves, feeling defeated, Father God. So I just pray right now that you will breathe a fresh wind, that you will send a fresh fire under your, light up your sons and your daughters this morning. Help them to recognize that even though things are not going the way that they wish, the way that they thought, it does not mean that you have lost control, that you are in control, Father God, and that as long as you are in control, that you are using us, that you are will strengthen us, that there are folks around us that can use our words of encouragement, they can use our hugs, our smiles, our prayers. And so, Father God, let us not be selfish. Let us not consider it an inconvenience. Let us not feel like we're unworthy. Let us not feel like we're incapable because of what we're struggling with, Father God, that we can let folk know that even in the midst of what we are dealing with, that we love you and we trust you, Father God. So, Father God, let this message go as far and as wide as you would have it to go, so that every warrior in your kingdom will know that we are called to be recruits, that we are called to be warrior makers, because Jesus is praying for us today. Whew, thank you, Jesus. Whew. Just pause right there and just let that just sink in. Jesus is praying for you. He's praying for you, Jeanette. He's praying for you, Danielle. He's praying for you, Andrea. He's praying for you, Irene. He's praying for you, Priscilla. He's praying for you, Angela. Come on, he's praying for you, Nyoka. Monica, he's praying for you. Shakinya, he's praying for you. Regina, he's praying for you. Tega, he's praying for you. He's praying for you, Suzette. He's praying for you, Denise. Cheryl, he's praying for you. Come on, somebody. He's praying for you today. Karina, he's praying for you. 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 Now receive the strength from God to go forth today and encourage, uplift. Go build a warrior today. Not just be a warrior, but build a warrior. Amen. I love you all with all of my heart. Thank you for allowing me to just be passionate and to share with you what God placed on my heart and to let you know you will recover. You know why? Because we're going to do this thing together. We're going to recover together, and we together are going to build a powerful army for God. No, Satan, we're not going to be a recruit of yours, and we are not going to join your army and be a part of your harvest. In fact, we're going to depopulate your harvest. I love you all. I pray that you all have a fantabulous Friday. May the Lord just be with you and give you peace. Don't forget to share. And God willing, guess what? We will be back together again next week to do this thing all over again. Thank you for allowing me to share. I never take that lightly. Have a blessed day, everybody. Love you. God bless you, Brother Bobby. Amen. You will recover, Nyoka. Amen. Love you too, Tega. Auntie Kathy, love you, Auntie Kathy. The scripture was Luke 22, 31 and 32. And look it up in the Voice translation. All right. God bless you, Andrea. Love you all.